Your students bring a wealth of experiences, identities, cultures, and ways of being to your class. Your instructional decisions can have a powerful impact on this diversity in your community of learners. It's why creating a culture of self-expression and inclusivity is paramount. Consider the phrase, "What I see can be me." If students see themselves reflected in what they're learning, they're more likely to be engaged and imagine themselves capable of mastering the subject matter. To support multiple perspectives in your creative class, ask yourself, who are the creators of the course materials your students are engaging with? Does that content provide opportunities for students to see themselves and experience a broad range of perspectives? What groups or experiences are represented in your content? Are all individuals represented equally? The ability to share your point of view is at the heart of creative self-expression. If you've developed trust in your classroom dialogue, discussion, and community, in the words of Zaretta Hammond, trust frees up the brain for other activities such as creativity, learning, and higher order thinking. To build that sense of trust and safety in your class, create opportunities or expectations for students to reflect on their identity and experiences. Connect that to their learning. Amplify their voice and confidence. Let's hear from creative educators to learn what diversity and inclusion mean to them.
Diversity and inclusion means equal access to the curriculum, equal access to viewpoints, equal access and voices when it comes to that whole creative process, the way things should be done. It shouldn't be that a person's viewpoints are hindered in any way, shape, or form based on any of the subjective biases that we have in society. We should all be able, in an educational setting, in any setting actually, to be able to actually voice what it is that we feel and our voice be a valid contributor towards that final outcome. Again, it comes back to that whole idea of having a safe space to voice your opinion, share ideas with your peers without feeling as if your voice won't be heard.
Providing a classroom that is welcoming and meets the needs of students from all over the world with different abilities, different cultural backgrounds, different strengths, different items for improvement. And it just makes the educational experience more rich because we're able to learn about one another.
To me, diversity and inclusion mean that every educator and student in the classroom, in the building, has a voice and should have an opportunity to share that voice.
An instance where diversity and inclusion were included and met the needs of all students was when my 10th graders last year studied The Catcher in the Rye. And because that is a young adult book, every student felt included. Every student could see themselves in the main character and in the struggles this main character went through in a coming of age, in a situation of grief, and how that adolescent was able to overcome that by reaching out for help in the end. And every student learned something new about how reaching out for help when you need it is a source of strength. And the students also learned resilience.
There are so many examples that I've had as experience in the classroom, both as a practitioner, as a senior leader, observing in classrooms where diversity and inclusion were key points, key factors in the achievement of students. One of those examples is a specific cohort had students in there that had language as a barrier. They couldn't access the English language as well as their peers. And technology was used. There were translator apps that were used so they could press what was actually spoken out verbally in their home language as well. And those types of things, you see the joy on the students' faces. You can see their eyes light up when they realize actually this barrier, this thing that was kind of setting them apart from everybody else in the class, it's totally been destroyed. And now they're part of everything that's going on. It's such a joy to see.
So I'll give one example here. One of the courses we teach is designing games. This is a coding course for children. And a lot of the characters that people could pick was much more skewed towards those that boys liked a lot. So the guys were excited, but the girls not so much. Once we included more characters that were appealing to girls as well, what ended up happening was that the experience became much more exciting, and we saw that more girl children were saying that, hey, I like to design games as well, which was not something we saw earlier. It was like one small example. We're learning from this and trying to see what more such blind spots exist.